This video will walk through exercise 1 step by step. The first step is to log into your virtual environment. For these exercises, we'll be using the PyClient O1 machine and the user PySchoolStudentO1 along with the password you were given. Once we're logged in, we can open up Google Chrome and navigate to the PyWeb API homepage. Generally, this will be the name of the PyWeb API server, either hostname or FQDN, followed by /PyWeb API. From this homepage, we can see a link to the help documentation that is hosted internally within the PyWeb API. This same information can also be found online at our techsupport.osisoft.com site. Let's see how we can navigate through the PyWeb API using the links provided from the homepage. If we click on the system link, it takes us to a page with some different information about the PyWeb API itself. We can follow the user info link to see which account we are authenticating as, and we see that the PyWeb API has indeed identified our PySchoolStudentO1 account. Observe that at the top of the page we are given links to specific help pages for the endpoint that we are at. If we go back to the system default endpoint, we can click the status link and see more information about the PyWeb API, including how long it has been running since startup. From the home page, we can click on the data server link, which takes us to a list of the known PyData archives. Click the points link under the data server PySRV01. If we use Ctrl F and search for the tag name Sinusoid, we can find the description of the tag. The self link takes us to an endpoint specifically for this PyTag. Click on the attributes link and we see the point configuration attributes, including the compression deviation. Now, use the hyperlinks to navigate back up the hierarchy to PySRV01 by clicking on the point link and then the data server link. Back at the home page, we can navigate to AF Data as well by clicking on Asset Servers. Click the Databases link under AF Server PySRV01. Click the Elements link for the new green database. We can see the root elements and navigate down the hierarchy by clicking the Elements links. Click the value link to show the attribute values for the B210 element. And we can see the value for the B210 fuel savings attribute here. Outside of the browser, let's take a quick look at the AF configuration database for the PyWeb API. Open PySystem Explorer and navigate to the configuration database. We can drill down to find the PyWeb API element for PySRV01. If we click on the system configuration element for this instance, we see configuration attributes for our PyWeb API. For example, we can look at the authentication methods attribute, which controls the protocols that PyWeb API allows for authentication. For our instance, we see that both Basic and Kerberos are enabled.